Every Friday from 3 to 4, you can find me at the rec center. Or rather, 100 feet above the rec center. Every Friday from 3 to 4, I conduct health assessments through PolyFit, Cal Poly's kinesiology club that specializes in helping students lead healthier lives. There's various tests that we practice, but today I'm going to show you how to do a resting heart rate test, and a blood pressure test, and how to calculate your BMI. So, the heart rate test is always the first test because it's when the patient is most relaxed. So, what is your resting heart rate? Your resting heart rate is the number of times your heart beats per minute, and it's an important measure of physical fitness because the lower your heart rate is, the more efficient your heart is at pumping blood throughout your body. So for this first test, I'm going to need a volunteer to like sort of demonstrate how heart rate works. So, oh, it's perfect. Okay.
Stage
volunteer. Yes, stage. I see.
Okay.
It's definitely random.
So, I'll do the first step with the volunteer, and then after that we can do it together. So first you're going to want to take your left index finger and your left middle finger. Okay, I need your laser right hand. Okay, so you take your left index, left middle finger, and then you're going to locate the radial artery, which is on the right hand, it's like right. You're going to try to find a pulse. There we go. Okay, and then once you find the pulse, you set a timer for 15 seconds, and then calculate that number by 4. So you guys want to like just count to 15 for me? So whenever you guys are ready, just count out loud.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16.
So I counted 19 beats. 19 times 4 is 76. So take a seat. Thank you. So that brings her resting heart rate at 76. You know, that's a pretty normal number. But now if you guys want to check your own heart rates, you can do that. So raise your left index, left middle finger, and then place it like right here. You're going to feel a pulse. Let me know when you guys feel a pulse, and then I'll start the timer for 15 seconds. Yeah. Everyone feel a pulse? All right, ready, and start counting. So now that you have that number, multiply it by 4, and then so what does that all mean? According to the American Heart Association, a normal resting heart rate should be in between 60 and 100 beats per minute. So what does a higher number, what were some of your numbers, just out of mouth?
48.
68. 48.
48.
60. So a lower heart rate indicates that, you know, I can guess that you're probably an athlete, just looking at you, right? So your heart is more efficient at pumping blood and oxygen throughout your body, which is why your heart rate is well lower than someone who's not as athletic as you, right? So what does a higher heart rate mean? A higher heart rate indicates lower levels of physical fitness, a higher blood pressure and weight, and higher levels of circulating blood. The next test we're going to go over is blood pressure. It's really similar to a heart rate, but there's a few key differences. So what is blood pressure? When your heart pumps blood throughout your body, blood and oxygen, blood pushes against the arteries and it creates a pressure. That blood pressure is the measurement of force applied to the artery and pulse. So to measure blood pressure, we need a blood pressure cup, which is this thing right here. I wasn't able to bring in a blood pressure cup today, because they just said no to me, but yeah. So there's 5 parts of a blood pressure cuff. There's the pump, the dialer cuff, the valve, and the actual stethoscope. Going on to the actual test. So there's 3 steps, really simple. You wrap the blood pressure cuff around the patient's arm, pump it up until the dial reaches 200, and then deflate it. And then once you reach, once you hear the first thump, you want to note that number down, and then the second thump, you want to also note. So once you have those 2 numbers, you have your blood pressure. normal blood pressure is 120 over 80, and anything lower than that is an indicator of hypertension, which means super high blood pressure, which can lead to heart attacks, strokes, and heart kidney disease. So, this next one, BMI, is really, really simple. All you need is your height and weight. So this is the formula for BMI. Right now, we're running out of time, so I can't have you guys calculate it, but I'll show you guys my BMI. So this is the chart we use for calculating BMI. Under 18.5, that puts you at underweight. It's a measure of how much body fat is on your body. So when we look at my BMI, I'm 174 pounds, and then I'm 5'10", so that's 70 inches. And then multiplying that by 703, I get 25 as my BMI. Now, if you look at 25 on the BMI scale, that says that I'm overweight. Right? And according to this, the most important takeaway here from this entire presentation is that these are just numbers, they're just measurements, and that they should not define, they should not define how you think or how you think about yourself, or your self-worth, or anything like that. Right? So according to this BMI scale, I'm overweight. Just looking at myself and looking at my last presentation, I don't think I'm overweight. The bottom line here is last week was about this thing a week here at Cal Poly. So I was at the gym, and then they have a assortment of weighing scales, right? And then for Buck This Stigma Week, they have little signs there that said, this number on the scale does not define who you are, your self-worth, or how happy you should be. And the bottom line here is these numbers, these measurements, at the end of the day, they're not a true measure of who you are. How happy and how healthy you are should come from up here and not a number on the scale. So if you want to see the rest of the test, the product that offers Friday 3 to 4.